Hello there, it's Mayrama with another video for you, and this time I want to talk about physics. Yes, these physics. I want to talk about physics. So, the discussion is centered around the fact that the only thing more fun than physics in a video game, you can quote me on this, is more physics. Yes, it's true. Because physics is trying to simulate nature and life. And life is always the most fun, right? Whee, see, come on. You can't beat that. Now it's over here. It's never in the same place. There's only one tiny little problem, which is that I haven't blown these things up yet. Alright. That wasn't what I was going to say. Yeah! Well, that was that. So, my point proven, I hope, that physics is great. Right? So, one problem. What happens when all the physics things get blown up, but you still want more? And in a real project, well, this is a real project, all of which I'm giving to you, by the way, but in a big project, just reloading the level just to reposition the physics is gonna take a little while, right? And it's a lot of overhead. Plus, maybe you don't want to restart the whole level, you just want a little playground to play in. So wouldn't it be great if you could reset the physics and do it again and again and again and never have to stop? That's what I'm saying. Alright, watch this. Ready? See this? This is a button. Click and they're back. Of course, you probably might have seen this already in my other videos, but I'm going to show you how to do this because this doesn't require any C++. This is just game logic stuffs. And I wanted to share it with you so that we... Where did it go? I wanted to share this project with you so that you can now create your own editor resetting system in just a few little steps. It's not that complicated. And let's do one more. I want to demo one other aspect of the physics system I set up here. So you see the blue ones, they don't actually get blown up, right? So watch the blues, they go wee, they move, they get pushed around, but they don't actually blow up, and then you see the chain reaction of the AOE. But yes, now I'm going to show you how you can set up a system like this, so you can reset the physics as much as you want, really lightweight. I'm not destroying and recreating any actors. No actors were harmed during the making of this video or the game mechanic itself. They're just faking it. They're just playing, okay? So it's very low memory overhead. There's one. So for each one of these boxes, there's only one box. That's actually a statement. I know it sounds a little bit like gibberish, but this is a Unreal Engine tutorial by me, so of course it might sound a little strange at first, but the truth is, there are five boxes on this platform, and as many times as you've seen them blow up into tiny little smithereens of rainbow particles, none of them have ever been... No destroy actor has been called on any of these actors. So it's not just... It's not a reset that's expensive. It's as lightweight as it gets. The only charge for admittance to this perpetual rainbow party is UE4. And hey, UE4 is free to the first 1 million, right? So, or UE5 now. I don't know if the license is the same, but my point is you're just paying for GPU particles. That's it. Nothing else. And those, you can probably support lots of those if you have a computer that can run Real Engine. So, very lightweight is my point. Alright, let's see how it works. Ready? So, the button is a floor button. That's just a trigger thing. I'll talk about that in a different tutorial. Let's start with the base class. So the base class of the physics fun thing is just that it's simulating physics, but there's this handy little event called editor reset. And editor reset is just a custom event. You just go and type custom, right? Add custom. There it is. And now you have this powerful, powerful tool. This is me loving blueprints. Maybe you weren't expecting a video like this from Rama, but it's true, I do love blueprints too. The synergy of blueprints, C++, and level blueprint is life. New life. fun and joy. So, editor reset is just a custom event, but now there's so much power, which you'll see in a second. I'll explain shortly. So the blue ones, they can't be destroyed, right? So all I do is I reset the actor location and rotation, and I clear all velocity values, because if you just reposition them but they still have velocity, they're going to go all over the place. Now, the mysterious, the most complicated part of this tutorial is right here. How do we determine these values easily so that as you create objects and place them, which I guess I have to now prove, I had to do it, you can tell everybody at Epic, I just had to do this. And this pillar shall forever remain in this project, which I'm giving to you so you can see what I had to do. So I just made those as soon as they're made, ready to go, right? And you saw the AI just triggered a reset right there. Ah! Okay, all right, let me try that again. I want to hit one twice. Let's try the bottom. Ah, okay. All right. Other logics that are fun. So I really want these to blow up on the first hit. Why? Because reasons. So let's just do that, shall we? So F4, type in joy. When in doubt, just type joy. Okay, that didn't work, but it usually works. Let's try this. Projectile, hit, health. All right. It'll be joy in a second. I have to do this. You know how Unreal Engine is. You have a vision, you think of something great, and Unreal Engine helps you do it. Okay, I just want this, right? You have to see this one. Okay, I looked a little too high. Oh, but I can do it again without I have an interesting idea. Alright, well, I want to just try one thing. I want to try blowing up the thing in the middle. Can't you see how bored I'm not? Oh my god. Okay, top-down's really fun. I'm supplying the sound effects for it. Ah, it just never gets boring. Oh, it's always entertaining. All right, let's try to hit one of these into it. All right, let's try to just knock it. Okay, this is not going to go well for our pillar. Let me try just knocking it over with the blue one. Ready? Got my little blue battering ram here. Okay, let's go. Let's go get it. Go get it. Talking to my blue box. Go get the... Okay, the yellows have... Oops. Alright, so you get the idea. You can goof around as much as you want, really lightweight. How? How is this done? How is it that as soon as I placed these new actors in the level blueprint, I could instantly reset them to their editor position? For some of you, this is abundantly obvious, what I'm about to say, but the magic never fades, right? Some things are worth repeating, even though they're already true. And it's called the constructor script of a blueprint. Very different than C++, because C++ doesn't know what a level blueprint is, but a construction script does. So one of the joys of Unreal Engine is that when you have an actor and you move it around in your blueprint, the construction script is called every time you move the object. That's not the same as a C++ constructor, different entity, really. A blueprint construction script is designed anytime you change this thing in your level blueprint, it updates, it reruns, and that's what sets editor location and editor rotation every time, so I never have to think about it again. The alternative, in case you're wondering why this is so joyous, is that if you just created a variable called editor location and you didn't set it in construction script, you'd have to update it manually every single time you move an object, which is just not something we do, right? That's not a thing. I've done it because I forgot about the construction script. So there's a lot of stuff to remember in Unreal Engine, okay? Alright. I don't even know why it's so entertaining. It just is. Some things... I have an idea. Alright, ready? I just had to know what would happen if I was right in between them. Okay, so where did they go? They're gone. Oh, they're back. Okay, so let's get to the heart of this now. So that's for a non-destructible. In construction script, they're set. And then in editor reset, I reposition them. But this is for the blue ones. What about the destructibles? So over here, please note, remember I said it was just an event, but it had so much power? This is the event from the superclass. This is a base class. This is a child of the physics fun that you just saw. But this one is a different shape and a different color. Construction script is empty. Make sure to call parent because that's what you were just looking at, right? This is the core of blueprint class hierarchy. But now what formerly was just an event that just said custom event is now a thing. It's now an official part of the subclass's logic chain. And if you see here, add event versus call, if you add the event, now you are able to add call to parent, which runs the logic from the superclass, which you just saw. This is the parent call. So what's red here is beige over here. And then you connect it, and now you can run extra logics that only pertain to the subclass, and the subclass is destroyable. So the subclass has many features, one of which is that it has health, which you saw me demo earlier. When you set the thing to be destroyed, I'll show that in a second. This is the particle system for indicating damage. It doesn't start active, you have to activate it. And then explode initiate. Oh, and the way that the particle systems aren't spawned, nothing is spawned. Nothing is created or destroyed in this entire demonstration except those GPU particles, and I bet they're recycled too somewhere. So deep inside your computer. So what I'm trying to get to is this is a particle system, and if I turn auto activate off here, now I have one particle system. You can count them, one. And you can fire it off as many times as you want. Now, for a one-off particle, like something you're not planning to see very often, it's probably not efficient to do this. But for something that's going to repeat over and over and over again, like with an editor reset feature, it's extremely efficient. You don't need a particle pool. You don't need to try to pull your components and reuse them. You can just reuse the one that comes with the box. Comes with the box. It's not inside the box. Well, actually it is. It's right in the center. Anyway, so that's the fire indicator that gets deactivated on editor reset. And then here's a little boolean I set up for whether an explosion has been initiated to avoid a chain reaction of explosions among the AoE damaging yellow boxes, which would cause an infinite loop. And let's look at set destroyed now. Set destroyed gets rid of all velocity first. Short delay to make sure that the velocity has time to register that it's been set to zero, because the physics tick is slightly different than the game engine tick, so I want to give it a little time. Ideally, you should like check for that a tick has passed using a boolean, like a tick occurred or something, but I'm being a little lazy here. Really, this should be event tick should say like flag, tell me when the next tick has occurred, and then I should do this to guarantee, because if the frame rate is slow, this may or may not work. But 0.05, pretty good. So basically set destroyed, if you're setting it to be destroyed, you hide it, turn physics off, and turn off collision. That's it. Now it's gone. Nobody will ever hear from that box ever again until you set destroyed to false again. And the explosion logics are not that complicated. Do AoE damage is very complicated. I'll probably do a different tutorial on that because it's complicated. That's all AoE damage. I'm not pretending that it's complicated because I'm zoomed out. It's probably blurry in my video. No, it's actually complicated. Complicated because you don't want to crash the engine when you have a whole bunch of boxes that are close together. So, anyway, it's not quite my focus, though. So my focus is the fact that I'm reusing, and plus I'm giving you the projects, so you can just look at AoE damage all day on your own. So I'm focusing on the fact that editor reset was not a thing, and then in the superclass it became a thing. Just a custom event, looks so, frankly, rather like an apple on a table. Just nothing that fancy. But now, it's amazing, because now you can subclass your logics, and all you ever have to do to trigger your blues to reset, to trigger your yellows to reset after possibly having exploded quite entertainingly, is to go and set up some logic for where you're going to get all actors of your base class and call editor reset. Now, for blue, you know what that does. Now, how come we don't have yellow listed here? Because it's a subclass of physics fund. Again, blueprint inheritance logic, class inheritance. And so as a result of, and by the way, I don't check who the activating unit is, which means the AI can reset. Actually, the boxes could reset themselves if one wanders into the trigger volume. So these three little nodes, that's it. That's the whole logic. I took a long time to explain it. It's not that complex of a logic. It was complex for me to figure out originally. I've been designing editor reset logics like this since the beta of UE4. Actually, even in UE3, I was prototyping it. But now, in UE5, I'm giving it to you, this logic for how you can reuse with maximum efficiency all the resources of Unreal Engine to constantly play with physics funds, whatever you want to call them. They're just called physics funds, I guess, plural. So, that's it. I have there's some yearning within my being, I think, for this. They're probably going to fall over. Let's see. Because it's slightly off. No, I made it. Okay. Alright, I just have to know. Okay, you know what I'm probably thinking, right? I mean, if it was that cool with a few, what happens if there's more? Alright, let's see. Alright, so for that to work, I gotta reset and get them before they fall over. Ready? 3, 2, 1, go. Alright, I would actually like to see it go off though. Oh, AI shot it. Where am I? What happened? What day is it? Okay, let's go over here. Okay, let's just start from the bottom up. You know, maybe one of you who observed this video can tell me why this is so entertaining. I don't know why it's so entertaining, but it feels very cathartic. Okay, well, there you have it. That was my demonstration of quickly setting up an editor reset feature for the most entertaining thing you could ever do, which is physics. Okay, have fun today.